at UPMC to validate the algorithm, we took 100 consecutive cases of core needle biopsies diagnosed by GU experts, and we challenged the IBEX algorithm to perform diagnoses on those cases. We chose cases with multiple parts, including benign and malignant cases, and that amounted to about 1,600 slides. That these were whole site images on which the algorithm had to perform to screen, detect, and diagnose cancer. At the end of the validation study, we were amazed that the algorithm performed so well. We found that the algorithm, the area under the curve, was close to near perfect, not only for the diagnosis of prostate adenocarcinoma, but also for Gleason scoring and other additional features that the algorithm was able to perform for us. In addition, we were very excited by the fact that the algorithm could generate a pathology report for us with a diagnosis of cancer, the Gleason score, perineural invasion, and even capture images and generate a report for us, which was highly efficient and very accurate, with sensitivities and specificities as good as our GU expert pathologists.
In order to provide an accurate diagnosis, we as pathologists often, when we have a positive diagnosis of cancer, share the case with another pathologist. What we don't do, and which should be done, is to actually even share some of the negative biopsies that don't have cancer. What AI does is it screens the biopsies agnostic of whether there is cancer or not, and almost to an extent when it is applied, provides 100% QC in looking for areas that are not cancer and identifying the areas of cancer. So in effect, it's 100% prospective quality control or quality assurance to the pathologist. So in order to check the reliability of the AI algorithm, one of the questions that we asked is, what is the utility of the IBEX algorithm in the diagnostic workflow of prostate biopsies? This question was asked in a large network of pathology laboratories in the south of France called Medipath. The study was comprised of 100 patients who were initially diagnosed as not having cancer. In these 100 patients, they often get multiple biopsies, and so the study set comprised of 800 slides. The study was set up and the instrument and algorithm was calibrated in such a way that the sensitivity of detection of cancer was 97% and the specificity once identified was 99%. In the study, 15 patients who were initially diagnosed as being benign were flagged off as having been suspicious for cancer. So the study comprised of 25 slides from these 15 patients that were then subject to further expert review. The study found that 12% of the patients, or 12 patients who were diagnosed as not having cancer, were actually had cancer as confirmed by one of two experts, and I had the opportunity and privilege to review these slides. In the 12 patients who were initially diagnosed as being benign, when we go back and look at which were the cases that were missed, the misses spanned a spectrum and a gamut of pathology. While as expected, there was some small foci of cancer that was missed, Interestingly and unexpectedly, we found that foci larger than 3 millimeters were sometimes missed, and there were higher grade cancers, Gleason score 4+3, that were also missed in the study. So my overall impression was that I would have expected that the pathologists who may not have the experience or who have high volume of cases to look at may miss small foci of cancer. But what was interesting to find is that there were some cases that were larger volume or of higher grade cancer. So my take-home message from this study is that AI is a perfect companion for pathologists who are looking at a lot of diagnostic material or may not have the expertise to look at this material with that level of confidence.
In this era where we have a decrease in the number of pathologists or residents really coming into pathology programs, and we have an increase in the number of cases that we have to diagnose, there is really a mismatch there. So that's going to be a very big challenge for us going forward. AI is important because we're going to be able to pretty much QC every single case. Right now, if we look at prostate, for instance, 65% of those cases are negative, and that's only seen by one pathologist. Most positive cases are seen, are shared by the pathologist. In this case now, we'll get 100% QC review of all of our negative cases. So I think that's a tremendous value, both to the pathologist, but more importantly to the patient. So we'll really be decreasing and hopefully eliminating the false negative. This is going to really assist the pathologist. And I think we'll see this as a progression of different steps from a digital assistant to a triage, and then finally to a primary diagnosis.
Core Plus, currently we are already digital. We are doing all our biopsies through the digital system. We have a scanner in place. We have our workflow in place, and we've been using that for the past couple of months. We decided to choose IBEX because they were able to provide a very practical solution in AI, and that was already being routinely used in clinical practice. The IBEX second read solution works perfectly with our workflow because it can work in the background while the pathologists are looking at the cases and making their diagnosis. The IBEX solution can be analyzing the prostate biopsies and give us the feedback that we need to close the case. In addition to cancer, the IBEX solution allows us to identify important pathological features like high-grade pain, inflammation. Even it would suggest the Gleason score for the tumor, and also identifying perineural invasion and other important things that have to go into the report. It's very exciting times now in pathology to be able to analyze these algorithms and see how they can become solutions that help us do a better job at taking care of our patients.